a 7-passenger family SUV, this thing sounds absolutely amazing. My name is Omar, and today I'm test driving the Audi SQ7. I've already done an in-depth review of the new Audi Q7, so make sure you check that out. Link is in the description below, or it's popping up in the right-hand corner right now. But this here is the Audi SQ7, and this thing makes 500 horsepower from a twin-turbo V8, and man, this thing is really fun to drive. That said, we're gonna do things a little bit different today. I'm just gonna go for a drive and tell you all about the SQ7. Don't worry, I'll still highlight the cool and interesting features of the SQ7, but I'm gonna focus more on how this thing drives and what it competes with. But before I do, make sure you hit that subscribe button, make sure you hit like. All right, let's do this. Now, since this is a performance SUV, let's talk about power first, horsepower and torque. Power comes from a 4-liter twin turbo V8, making 500 horsepower and 568 pound-feet of torque. This thing will do 0 to 60 in just 4.3 seconds with a top speed of 155 miles an hour, which you'll probably never hit in your life. If the standard Audi Q7 is too boring for your family SUV mover needs, then the SQ7 will definitely provide that extra boost that you're looking for. The twin turbo V8 under the hood has plenty of power for your daily needs, but the SQ7 also has a little bit of a different suspension upgrade to help it handle better. You have a bunch of different drive modes. You have off-road, all-road, comfort, auto, and you're probably keeping it dynamic the most. And then you have individual, where you can set everything to your personal liking. I like to keep it in individual, where everything is of the sportiest setting. Except for the suspension, I like to keep the suspension in comfort. Why? Well, I like a smooth ride quality, but I also enjoy a lot of power, so that's how I like my setting. Speaking of smooth, the SQ7 has a very, very smooth ride quality, and even though this is supposed to be the high performance and sportier version of the Q7, it still retains the smooth ride quality and comfortable ride quality that the Q7 is known for. But for now, let's keep it in dynamic mode, because that exhaust sounds amazing. Honestly, it feels like I'm driving a V8 powered muscle car right now. So good. Unfortunately though, that exhaust does have a rev limiter, so if you're sitting at a red light or in a parking lot trying to show off your exhaust sound, you won't really be able to do it and you'll look a little bit crazy. I hate rev limiters with a passion. I mean, why else would I shell out this much money for a performance SUV and not have it sound like a performance SUV by showing it off sitting at a red light or a parking lot? I'm just a loser like that. So how does the SQ7 compare to its German rivals? You have the BMW X5 M50i, and then you have the Mercedes AMG GLE 53. The GLE 53 carries a 6-cylinder turbo engine pumping out about 429 horsepower, and it'll do 0 to 60 in 5.2 seconds, which makes it almost a full second slower than the SQ7. How about the X5 M50i? Well, that's much closer to the SQ7 in terms of power and performance. The X5 M50i carries a twin turbo V8 as well, which pumps out 523 horsepower, and that will do 0 to 60 in 4.1 seconds. So while the GLE 53 is more worried about comfort, the BMW X5 M50i is way on the performance side, and I think the SQ7 hits that mark right in the middle with a perfect balance of comfort and sport. In dynamic mode, the power delivery is instant. This twin turbo V8 is never ending. And in dynamic mode also, your steering wheel gets a little bit tighter to give you that extra confidence when you're trying to throw it in corners. Unfortunately, there's no Audi RS Q7 to go after the X5 M or the GLE 63S, but I'm hoping Audi eventually changes their mind, because they can do this performance game really well. Now let's break down the pricing details, because all this power is pretty expensive. The cheapest of the three is the GLE 53, starting at around $72,000, but don't forget, that doesn't have a twin turbo V8 under the hood. The BMW X5 M50i starts at around $83,000, and the SQ7 starts at $85,000 for the Premium Plus and $91,000 for the Prestige. So yeah, these are highly priced performance SUVs. But even though it is expensive, it does come with a long list of standard features. Now let's talk about the exterior design for a few minutes, because if you're paying extra for a high performance Q7, you want it to look a little bit more exciting than the regular Q7. Well, that's not the case here, and I actually kind of like that. It is a bit difficult to tell the SQ7 apart from the Q7 unless you look a little bit closely, especially if you get it in this Daytona gray color that I have here. To quickly spot the differences between the SQ7 and the Q7, you could just look at the quad exhaust, or you can look for the SQ7 badging. There are other S-specific design elements like the S model bumpers and platinum double flat single frame grille, but that's really about it. But I actually like the fact that this thing looks like a sleeper, because no one will expect you to go from 0 to 60 in 4.3 seconds when you're stopped at a red light, and that's what makes this thing fun. So how's the inside? The first thing you'll probably notice once you hop inside the SQ7 are these awesome seats. These are standard here, and you can get them in black, rotor gray, or Aris red like I have here. I actually like red leather seats quite a bit, especially when you can see them from the outside, but I might be alone there. But overall, these seats are very comfortable. You know, I feel like when most luxury automakers do a performance version of a model in their lineup, the seats always tend to become less comfortable, but that's not the case here at all. These seats are very well bolstered, and you can actually adjust the bolstering around your back and thigh area. You do get heated seats as standard, but if you want cooled front seats and massaging front seats, you'll have to add on a package or go for the prestige model. My test model here is the Premium Plus SQ7, and it adds on the executive package for $2,400, and that will give you cooled front seats and heated rear seats for the second row passengers, and it will also give you a very beautiful ambient lighting system. Audi's ambient lighting system definitely is really up there with the best. I think all German automakers do ambient lighting really well. Now, as a 7-seater, 3-row SUV, the Audi SQ7 is pretty spacious. You have almost 39 inches of legroom in the second row, and it's pretty comfortable. I'm about 6 foot tall, and another sixer can sit behind me without any issues. I think the GLE has the most amount of second row legroom, coming in at about 40 inches. The X5 has the least, and the SQ7 is right in the middle with 39 inches. Tech-wise, the Audi SQ7 comes standard with the dual-screen MMI infotainment system and the virtual cockpit display. And again, if you want a deeper dive into the MMI infotainment system and the virtual cockpit display, make sure you check out my Q7 review. I've gone into great detail many times about this whole setup, and this is one of the best setups in the industry. Reason being, it has a very, very small learning curve. You can just hop in here for about 15 to 20 minutes and get completely acquainted with the whole tech in here. I do wish that the top screen was a little bit bigger, but I guess it's okay because Audi is one of the few brands that integrates all these displays and tech very, very seamlessly. I do like the fact that there isn't a giant iPad sticking out from the center of my dashboard, so that's kind of nice. This is definitely the easiest infotainment system to use out of all the German luxury brands. I love the MBUX infotainment system from Mercedes-Benz, but it has like a bunch of themes and settings that you can mess with, and the BMW's infotainment system is just plain confusing. It takes some time to really get used to BMW's infotainment. Now, before I give you my final thoughts on the Audi SQ7, let me put in a few random things that I left to show all of you. You have 6 cup holders, 2 in the front, then you have 2 in the back for the second row passengers, and you have 2 more in the third row for the third row passengers, one right there and one right there. Here are the keys to the Audi SQ7. They look pretty nice, standard Audi key. You got a little nice S logo back here, and that's it. Door open and close sound from the outside. You don't have soft closed doors here. And from the inside, pretty solid. By the way, I do really appreciate the fact that Audi's offer you a key holder right near the cup holder. All right, now for the indicator and horn sound. Test indicator first. Pretty Audi-ish as usual. And now for the horn sound. Pretty solid, just like I expected it to be. So I will say that the Audi SQ7 really competes with the X5 M50i than it does with the GLE 53. And if you're looking for a performance family vehicle, I highly recommend test driving the SQ7 and also test drive the X5 M50i. Don't just take my word for anything. Always go and test drive everything that you want to take a look at, and then make your decision and see which one is the best fit for you. Now, there are some people out there thinking probably, hey, should I just get the SQ8 because it has the same twin turbo V8 under the hood? And while the SQ8 is more stylish than the SQ7, it does have a higher starting price tag of $89,100. But interestingly enough, the SQ8 has more second row legroom than the SQ7 at about 40 inches. This has 39 inches, so you get an extra inch of second row legroom in the SQ8. So if you don't care about a third row and want something a little bit more stylish, go for the SQ8, but keep in mind, you will be sacrificing some cargo capacity with the SQ8. Honestly, what it really comes down to is if you want to be in the coolest, latest, and most stylish Audi made in recent years. Personally, if I was going to go for an SQ whatever, it would be the SQ8, because I want to show off a little bit if I'm spending this kind of money. Either way, thanks for watching. Make sure you hit subscribe, make sure you hit like, make sure you follow me on Instagram and on TikTok. My handle is @OmarDrives. I'll catch you on the next one. Take care. Peace.